Welcome to this video. This is Vijay from Dino Code Academy. So in this video, we are going to design the UI for our category screen. So let's start this lecture. So I am actually open the project inside my Android Studio. So first click on this project tab. Just right click on this app level directory and go to new. And from there, just select the empty activity, create a new activity. And I'm going to name this activity as category. Then simply click on finish and wait for the Gradle to actually build the project for us. So simply hit add, because it is actually a Git, because I am using the version control system to this project, that's why the window is actually popped up. So here you can see now the activity is created. So inside of this categories activity, first we need to design the layout. So I'm going to click on this activity XML file, means the design editor of the XML. So from there I'm going to place some buttons. So here we are actually inside the constraint layout. So go to and show layout decoration. So it will gives you the decorations of the layout. So from there, just drag the button inside this constraint layout. So you can see the button is actually popped up. Just select and set the constraints to this button. Then also set the constraints to slider one. Yeah, again we need another button, so just control V, and this is going to just uncheck the constraint, and this one is actually like this, and here set it to this one. Then also we need to make the duplicate of this one. And also for this one, make sure the both are actually aligned properly. So I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. So yes, the both are actually aligned properly. So from the, I'm going to make it into 32, and this one is actually also going to be 32. Just align this one to this one. So first, and just attach with this one. So yeah, that is actually, and just remove the constraint, and also this one, and just set the constraint to this one, and this one is actually going for here. Let's place it at the center. So yeah, we have actually did it. Then go to the text mode of the XML, click on this preview tab so that we can see the preview as well. Then this is going to be BT, and I'm going to just simply here type it as history. So this is going to be history, and this one is actually for computers. And this one, which is a button 3, is actually going for our graphics, or you can see it as English. And this one is actually going for our maths. And I'm also going to specify the fifth button. Paste it. And the ID of this button is going to be 5. And it is going to place it here. So the first thing, I'm going to click it here and just removing the constraints. And also from the top one, just place it at the center here. Now this one is actually set it here, set the constraint to the top. Then it's actually the bottom constraint. Then hit set it here, and for this one, set it here. Place it inside it and just change the text to graphics. And for this one, just change the text to graphics. So this one is actually button 8. The ID, and change it here to graphics. Now it's time to change the height and width and dimensions. So first, make it as into 300 dp. So in my opinion, 300 dp is very large. So I need to make it into, I think, 150 dp. So 150 dp is not sufficient. I think it's going to be 200 dp. So yeah, 200 dp seems to be quite good. Not good, I think 150 is enough. And also we need to make the height as well 150 dp. Then simply copy this code and just paste it here, and also here, and also here. English one, and select this English one and also paste it here. Now again just simply rearrange it inside the layout editor. So now the layout is again and you click on this constraint to remove the constraint so that it can be movable. And just this graphics one is going to, and this one is actually going to here, and just make this computer ones to movable at this position. You can also use the card view if you want, but I'm not using the card view. Just make these two little bit at top. It's now perfectly aligned, and this one is actually, I'm going to increase the width to 250 dp. Note this one, that is this graphics one, is going to increase the width to 250 dp. So here you can see, now it's looking great. Now it's time to modify the content, so simply I'm going to specify here a background. So the background is going to be BT background, I think the play button BG, that's background looks like good. And just change the text color to dark black, hashtag and 3x0, and after that press the enter key and increase the text size to 22 sp. So this will, and then one thing we need to do more is actually text all caps is going to false. Then I'm going to simply copy this same code and paste it inside the all the other buttons as well. So the text is actually history here, and this is not the history when I need it. Make sure I'm getting the same, just only these two properties. Press enter key and paste it for this one. And I have actually forgot to copy the background one. So this is the background. I need to copy this one. And again, here I need to paste it. Right now, this one is actually, and here we can see the text size property is 22 sp, but this one doesn't having a text size property, so I need to type it here. Text size is going to be 22 sp. Let's cut it this code from here and paste it here. And also I need a text all caps property, so this one, let's copy this one and paste it at the end of here. So we want these three properties, so text size, text all caps and background. Copy it, paste it here, and also I have already pasted here, and also paste it here, that is this one, which is the last graphics one. So that's it, we have now successfully designed the layout. It's time to specify the background for the root layout. So just simply type it background, and this is going to be main background. That is a purple one. So that marks the completion for the designing. It's time to fetch all these views inside the activity. So we have button 2, button 3, button 5, and 4, and also then we have 8. So I'm going to make it into 6. For that, we need to close all the packages. And I'm going to click on this categories activity. So the first thing, we need to create a variable at the top of a button class. So simply type it here button. Press a tab key and then type it here bt, and then this is going to be history button, then simply bt, and this is going to be computers, and this is going to be bt, and this one is going to be English, and then here type bt, and this one is actually going for maths, and again here specify the comma and then type it here bt, and this one is actually for graphics. Now it's time to initialize all of these inside the onCreate. So first type it here bt, and it is going to be bt history. So type it here, find viewer ID and r dot id dot, and then here type the button 2. So here I need to specify the ID, but if I just change the IDs, then the layout placement will also change, because here you can see if I will change the IDs to these buttons, then the layout placement will be changed. So for that reason, I'm not going to change the IDs. So the button 3 is the ID for the English one. So duplicate it here and then type it here bit t, and just simply click on this English one. First I'm going to go with the English one. So it is going to for the button 3 for the ID of the English one. Then here it is going for the button computers. So this is for the bit t computers. Now the ID for the bit t computer is actually bit t 5. So make sure you actually specify the ID as soon as you place the button inside the layout screen. Then this is going for the maths, and it is a math, and here the ID for the math one is actually bit t4. And then the last one, which is graphics, the ID is going to be 6, and the name of the variable is going to be graphics. Then there are multiple buttons, and all of these are actually going to perform a on click. So it's better to actually override the, means implement the on click interface. So I'm going to type it here view.onClickListenerInterface. So when I click, press the alt enter, we need to implement the method. So I'm going to click on OK to implement the on click method. So first I need to set the listener. So here simply type it graphics.set on click listener, and here I will be typing this. After that I'm going to duplicate into 4 more times, and here I'm going to specify bit t maths, then here bit t computers, then bit t English, and then after that the last one is actually bit t history. So now we have set the listener to all of these buttons. So here we need to use the case switch case statement. So view dot, so here we need to type it a view dot get ID. According to the ID, we are going to perform the cases. So the first case is going to be case, and this is going to be the r.id. And if we get the button, which is a button, that is this one. And if we get this button, if we get the history, so here I will be writing one comment for the history, so that it will be more clear for you. And also we need to type it here a break. Instead of that, we need to start the intent by passing the bundle as a parameter, or you can use with the put extra method. So we are going to use the put extra method. So here I will be typing intent, and I will be typing into computers. So this will be used for sending the data of the computer, but actually we are history, because the button 2 is the ID for the history. So here, and then we need to type it here new intent, and then here we need to specify the name of the class, that is category. So category activity dot this, and after that we need to specify, so we want to go to the quiz activity, that is this one, dot class, then a semicolon. Then we need to use the method intent dot put extra. So it is an intent history dot put extra method, that is this one. Here we need to specify the key, so it is going to be category, and we need to store these values inside the constant. So I'm going to click on that and click a new file, that is a Java class, and it's going to be of constant. So it will host all the constants. So I want to add it into my git file as well. And instead of this constant, I'm going to create some public static constants. So simply type it here psfs, which is short for the public static final string. And here simply start typing the constant. And this is going to hold the value of computers. So computers, and just simply press the semicolon. Now I'm going to duplicate into 4 more times, and this is going to be history. And here specify the history, and this is here specify the English, and here specify the English, and then here specify the maths, and this one is actually, now the last one is actually a graphics, and just specify here a graphics as well. So now the all constants are now created. Now here just simply make a semicolon, and then simply type it here constant dot the class constants dot and the constant that you want to send it. So we want to send it history, and simply semicolon. Similarly, so for that, just simply copy it and paste it here. Copy it, I think it's not copied. And here change the ID to 3 and just see where the 3 ID is for the English one. So here type the English and then just change the intent object as well because we are in the same block. Now it's time to change it here. Copy it and paste it here. And then we need to change the category to English. Then also we need to start the intent because we are forgetting here to start the intent. So type it here, start activity, that is this one, start activity, and we need to pass the intent history as a parameter. And similarly, copy this code from here and paste it here. Copy it and paste it here. And again, we need to create another case for the other remaining three ones. So paste it. And the ID is time for the 4. So the fourth button ID is for what? It's actually for maths. So here type in the maths category. And then change the intent object name as well. Maths, and also change the intent object is going to be maths. And also for this one, maths. Then we need to change the category. So here type the maths. Similarly, we need to define for the computer one and also for the graphics one. Press the button key and here make some space. Just see the ID for the computer is 5. So here just make it into 5 and type it here computers so that it will become more clear for you. Computers, and then simply here type the object name as computers. Copy it, paste it, and then we need to change the category. So this time we actually want to send the computers. Then the last one for the graphics one. So now press it here, and here we need to change it into 6. This is for the graphics. And now it's time to change the object of the intent as well. Graphics, and then copy it, paste it. Copy it and paste it. So now the coding inside our categories activity is done. We are actually successfully send the data to the quiz activity. But before that, inside the play activity, we need to start the categories activity. So here we need to make change. Instead of starting quiz activity, we want to start the categories activity. So after doing this, just close this play activity and go to the quiz activity, that is this one. So we need to get the value of the intent. So here, before, after set up the UI, before fetching the DB, we need to pass the category to the fetchDB method. Means we need to receive the categories from the category activity inside this quiz activity onCreate method. So let's do it. So here we need to type it intent, and then the name of the intent, which is at this point of time, I'm going to name it as intent category to be more meaningful. And then I'm just simply going to type it here, intent. Then I'm going to create a global variable at the top of type string. So simply type it a private. It's going to be type of string. And this is for the category value. Because later on we need to pass this category value to the result activity as well. And you will see when I run the application. But problem we face. After getting the intent and declaring the variable at the top of the onCreate method here, we need to use this variable. So simply type it here, category. Make sure the category value, that is this one, this variable, and go to the equals to, and after that here simply specify the intent category. So I'm just going to make it into smaller caps so that to follow the naming convention of the Java. And here this is actually a string variable, so I'm going to type it here, intent category, that is this one, dot get string data, string extra, and then we need to specify the key. So the key that we actually sending, we need to copy this key and then paste it here, and after that we need to specify the semicolon. Now we have successfully get the category value inside of this category value variable. Now we need to use this variable inside the method where we actually pass the random text to the fetchDB. Now instead of fetchDB, we need to use the method. That's why I declare the variable as globally, so that we can use anywhere inside the class. So here I will be writing a comment calling the method with category. After that, it's time to run the application to see that everything is working fine or not. So I'm going to run the application into my virtual emulator. So here you can see application is now running. This is a splash screen. Now if I click on play, you can see we are now inside the categories activity. So if I select the computer one, now you can see it will fetch these 6 questions on the basis of the category that we have selected. So if I select and play this quiz again, and it's a wrong one.
Wrong.
And then again select it.
Wrong. Wrong.
And just this is the last one.
Correct.
So now confirm and finish. Our quiz is actually finished. Now we are inside the result activity screen. If I click on the main menu again we are inside the play activity. If I click it, and if I select the English one, then you can see now we are inside the English one, and you can see we are actually fetching the correct questions. So just simply select this correct one.
Wrong.
And this is a wrong one, I think. English phrasal is actually, this one is actually correct. Correct. Yes, this one is correct. Now we are inside the, again, in the result activity. If I click on main activity, click on play. Now it's time to fetch the maths question. So now we actually fetched the 2 questions of the math successfully. So 2 into 60 is actually 120.
Correct.
So that's the correct one. 5 into 5 plus 5 is 10. But I'm going to select the wrong one.
Wrong.
So yeah. Now successfully we are able to play all the activities. Now it's time to play the history one. So just select the history one, because we have only one question inside our database, or that is related with the history category. So it is actually used for money, but I have selected the wrong one. Now quiz is actually finished. Again, go to the main menu and click on play. If I select the graphics one, then you can see we are actually getting the same. So I have actually not changed the thing, I think. So this is a bug, and let me see. So here inside that, I have not changed the category for the graphics one. That is why we are getting the computer questions. So again, run it into my virtual emulator. So this is a bug, I found it here. Now this is a splash screen. Click on play, and if I select the graphics one, then quiz finished, and it will take us to the result activity. If I click on main menu, and if I click on play, and if I again click on English one, and select the one, and just simply
wrong.
This one, and then select this one,
wrong.
Now if I click on play again, then you will see our application gets crashed, and it will again restart the categories activity. So if I again show you, click on history one, select it and just click confirm.
Wrong.
And if I click on again play again in the result activity, then you can see our application gets stopped. And that is because we are not able to successfully start the application, means the quiz activity, because our flag, means our data that we have sent to the activity, is actually lost. So we need to resend this data back to the quiz activity from the result activity. So we can do this in the next video. So I'm going to show you how we can solve this error in the next video. So that's it for this video. If you like this video, then share it with your friends and whoever want to develop the application by using Android Studio and SQLite. And if you're new to my channel, then definitely subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon so that you can get a notification when I upload a new lecture. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you.